Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metrology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Hardly anybody knows, and hardly anybody bothers about it. They are all men of letters, flying dead letters, reaching them nowhere. And it's quite interesting to I'm a retired lecturer in metallurgy, not in theology. And I can tell you many things which these men of theology don't have any idea. So these sin, you know, and other things they are doing in the churches and corruption, you know, which the Messianic Jews brought in, are worth noting and emphasizing. So most people think that Messianic Jews, they know the best. It's not true. Whenever the Messianic Jew comes to a church to give a lecture, he is putting his rotten old testament in front. Daniel says that thing, this, and if you ask them a parable of the New Testament, they have no idea. Because all their life is in Torah. So here is something which is I've written. Why bother about these Messianic Jews? They corrupted the New Testament by introducing the term disciple, which bears nothing to Christianity. The root of the word disciple is discipline. And only the firstborn natural boys, 12 to 16 years old, you know, that needed disciplining through the moral laws of Moses. So the law and prophets, as you know, they were till John the Baptist. So after John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16, we have no law. Transgression against the moral law is sin, isn't it? So no sin after that one. And therefore no disciples of the rabbis, because rabbis, they apply moral laws. And the rabbis and Pharisees, Sadducees, they had the disciples. Remember when Jesus was eating at Matthew's place? Over there some Pharisees, Sadducees came here. Your people don't wash their hand. As the disciples of John the Baptist, Moses, Pharisee and Sadducee do. So those people, Pharisees, Sadducees, John the Baptist, they had disciples. Because they were moral teachers. Jesus is a moral, not a moral teacher. He is a preacher of gospel, supernatural. The moral apply to this natural self, our tribal self, which is in Yahweh or Brahma, but not to our soul, which is belong to Parbrahm or Elohim, which is of supernatural Father. We have no law and therefore no disciple to teach them the moral laws of Moses or the dead letters. And no more sins, because sins are transgression against the moral laws, but blasphemy, transgression against the Holy Spirit, which is inside you. When you have something inside and you tell from your mouth something different to somebody, that is called blasphemy. When Jesus was accused before the Pilate, the people who accused him, they were blasphemers. The blasphemers are not easy to be detected by the once-born Pilate. So that's why Jesus kept quiet, you know, because this foolish king, you know, who is hand in hand with these temple priests, the blasphemers, he will not know what if I tell him something. But he told him one thing, that you are sitting on this seat, so far you are speaking the truth. When you won't be speaking the truth, this seat will be gone. Your kingship will go. And that frightened him, you know. So, which is more serious than sins, blasphemy, that are sins are forgivable blasphemy is not forgivable and bears fruit as it did by bringing down the temple and throwing the husbandmen, the temple priests, you know, out of their trade. Jesus told them, you know, not one stone will be left on top of the other, because they were useless. And they were given 70 years, 10 times 7, to mend their way. When 70 years came, the temple was destroyed. In 66 AD, it had a great siege, and people died hungry. Remember, Jesus made 2,000 swine to drown into the lake. There was a man in that town, Gennesaret, who was locked in the graveyard. He was locked there because he was telling the people, look, this our rabbi is a hypocrite. He's doing wrong thing. And do the right thing. Listen to me. And they were being studious of the rabbi. They honored rabbi blindly. They were blind guides, blind needed by their blind guide. So they did not wanted to know what this man was telling them. But the rabbi told the people, you know, hey, look, that man is pointing finger at me for nothing. And lock him up in the silence of the graveyard. That's why he was locked in the silence of the graveyard. But because he had gospel in his heart, he wanted to tell people. There was a great urge, and he was breaking the chains and going again. The people locking again. And when Jesus came to know of these things, you know, then he went to that Gennesaret, to that man where he was locked in the graveyard. And when he went there, he came to greet him as the Son of the Most High. So he recognized that Jesus is the Son of the Most High. He honored him. And then Jesus told him, why you throw pearls before swine? If they don't want to listen to you, leave them alone. They will turn around and trample you. That's what they did, you know. They turned around and locked him in the silence of the graveyard. And many people have been killed, you know. Angel Stephen went to the temple to tell those swine in the temple, the temple priest, don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. Stop this business. But they were very angry. They wanted to make Jew outwardly, not of the heart. And they took him out and stoned him to death. Today the temple was destroyed in 70 AD because it was wine press good for nothing. Then they were making these Jews through circumcision. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only, not to the Gentile. Only the seed of Isaac can have circumcision. Not anybody born of the girl who marries a Gentile. He can't be circumcised and made a Jew, because it does not represent the seed. But they were making business out of them, putting millstone of ritual around their necks and getting money, generating money. And today, you know, when they entered this, the fold of Muhammad Sahib, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, when they entered that fold, you know, then they introduced many things. They introduced circumcision. Then there's a kippah over their head. Then kosher, which they call halal, and other things, you know, prayers and other things. But in the church, you know, they were resisted when they tried to introduce that the bishop should be circumcised and all that, you know, they resisted. And they could not apply that one. So there are many things they have done wrong, and I have put so many videos to explain everything. So if you look into them, you will get a lot of knowledge. End of the world is approaching. And those very people which they circumcise to make them their rich, their stooges for money, and in the fold of Hazrat Muhammad, they circumcised many from Iran, India, Pakistan, and other things. Are they the sons of Isaac? Are they of Semitic race? No, they are Aryan race, different race, Gentile. They did not need baptism, but they baptized them. Sorry, they did not need circumcision. They have circumcised them, making them the fake sons of Abraham. In fact, through the circumcision, they say bye-bye to their own tribal father. By saying bye-bye to their own tribal father, they become super bastard fanatic devils. So they have created them, you know. And end of the world is coming. It will be they who will be killing them. So you can't blame a third person for their suffering. They created their own enemies. And you will see how the temple will be destroyed, how the Israel will be suffering after 70 years. In 2018, it will be 70 years. Then there will be 5 more years of grace, tribulations, very hard one. When people were given the last chance to turn to God before there will be atomic war in 2023, in May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. Our Father knows better than I can tell. This is the man's wisdom, and to err is human. So bringing down the temple, throwing the husband out of their trade, but they have appeared in a much stronger form as Pope and his stooges, these fathers, you know, in church fathers. Jesus got rid of them, you know, where from they come. Nobody can stand between man and God, because you have to give your own account to God. So there are a lot of things you can learn, and if you are open-minded and you are seeking gospel cannot be pushed through the throats. Gospel is like a Eucharist wine which you can't pour from one cup into the other, because you can't give it. It's received from God only, one bottle held by God. So unless God gave you the gospel, you can't have it. Our Father God blesses you.